Hi, good morning students. Myself Rajkumar. So we are dealing with a topic called matter around us of class 9. Matter. A simple word which explains a lot. Matter. The things around us. For example, the building, the water we drink, the air we breathe, the chair, table, a duster, a book, a conical flask, everything is called a matter. So simply we can say that matter is made up of particles. Matter is made up of particles which occupies space or volume and has a mass. So for example, we can take this conical flask. It has a volume, it has a mass, and it is occupying a certain space. So we call this a conical flask as a matter. And in this matter, we have states of matter. So mainly we have three states of matter or three phases of matter. First one is solid, and second one is a liquid, and third one is the gas. So students, you may come across a lot of things which are solids. So can you give an example regarding the solid? Yes, it's a very good example. So just now we discussed about the conical flask. So this conical flask, it has a fixed shape, it has a fixed volume. So what are solids? Solids have a fixed shape and fixed volume. Next, coming across liquids. So what about liquids? It has a fixed volume and different shape. So we are taking amount of water in a conical flask, and we are taking a cylinder. So it's a conical flask, and next to it is a cylinder. So now I am pouring the water which is in conical flask into the cylindrical flask. The same amount of water or the same volume of water, I am pouring into a cylindrical flask. So we can see that the conical flask has been emptied now. The volume of this water is occupied by the cylinder. So what can we understand from this? So we can understand that there is the same amount of volume, but that water or liquids is depending upon the shape of the container. First, it was in a conical flask, and secondly, now present, it is in a cylindrical flask. So liquids have fixed volume and different shape. Now, you know well about gases. For example, we can take a balloon. Into that balloon, we can see the air particles. When there was air particles, we can see the balloon, the shape will be different. And then take a pin and make a hole in it. What will happen? The shape comes to its initial position. So we can see that it neither has fixed shape nor volume. Next, all these are a part of matter. So in this part of matter, again we are going to discuss about diffusion. So diffusion is the movement of air, vapors of scent, from an area to other area. For example, we can see, take an incense stick, flame it and keep it at a corner. We can see the vapors of scent from an area, it will move to another area. For example, we can take perfumes also. So when you spray a perfume to your body, what will happen? The person who is far from you can smell it. That means there was a movement of air, the vapors of scent, from a particular area to other area. It is called as diffusion. Now let us relate the diffusion to the three phases of matter. What are those? Yes. First one is solid, second one is liquid, and third one is gas. Now coming to gas, solids. What are solids? So in solids, diffusion will be diffused in solids. For example, you can take sugar crystals. At home, we are preparing lemon juice. Do we prepare? Yes, we prepare. So in that lemon juice, what we can put in it? We can take the sugar crystals and pour the sugar crystals into lemon juice. What will happen? The solids are diffusing into liquids. And next one, it has a fixed shape and fixed volume. And third one is interparticular spaces are high. What are interparticular spaces? The space between two solid objects. For example, you can take a flask, pour it as full of sand into it. What will happen? There will be no gap between the particles. That means between the sand particles. What we can say about solids then? In solids, the intermolecular spaces between them is the least. Now, coming to liquids. So in liquids, the intermolecular spaces are intermediate. What are intermediate? That means it doesn't have least space, it doesn't have high space. The space between the liquids are intermediates. Now come across to gases. So in gases, that's why we discussed about the incense-stick example. So in that example, we know that the vapors of incense stick is mixed with air molecules. So when it is mixed with air molecules, we can understand that. What we can understand? Yes, gases can diffuse into gases. Next one. So we discussed about. Yes. Next we'll deal with compressibility. So in this compressibility, we can take examples. For example, you can take a syringe. Take a syringe, pour some sand particles into that syringe, and with the help of piston, press it. So what will happen? There will be no compression between the solid particles. Whenever you press the piston also, the solid particles will not move forward. That means in solid particles, the compressibility, that means there is no compressibility in solids. Whereas in liquids, we can say a little bit of compressibility in liquids. Whereas gases, it is highly compressible. So for example, we can see CNG gases. It is compressed natural gas. In the word itself, we have compressed. That means portable. For example, the LPG gases we are using in our houses. They are examples of compressibility in gases. And next we are dealing with constant particles. The constant particles are very high in solids. In liquids, it is intermediate. Whereas in gases, it is high. So till now, we are discussing about matter, its phases. The three major phases are solids, liquids, gases, and we discussed about diffusion. And we have connected the diffusion with three states of matter, that is solids, liquids, and gases. And we discussed about compressibility also. So we have learned till now about solids, about liquids, and about gases. So I hope that you understood a lot from this. So a small assignment for you. It is an easy assignment. Write the difference between solids, liquids, gases. A small assignment. What you have learned from this video, you memorize yourself and put it into a tabular form. So thank you. I hope you understood well.